let's talk about why it is that you are suing the DNR.
Yeah, so this is really one of those cases, Meg, where you scratch your head and say, what in the world? Why is this happening? We are, our WMC Litigation Center is representing a husband and wife. They're about 70 years old, and they own a bicycle and skateboarding shop in Kenosha. And they're at that age where they want to retire and sell their business, and in fact attempted to do so and got an offer to purchase their business. And what happened when they went to sell was they were required to do an environmental review. And what they found out was that 60 years ago, there was, or probably more than 60 years ago, there was a gasoline station doing business on that property, which they had no idea about and was never disclosed to them. And the gasoline storage tanks that were buried underground and were removed years ago, but they had leaked. And so there's contamination on their property. And what the DNR is telling them is you can't, even though you had nothing to do with this contamination, you were not responsible for the pollution, but it's your responsibility to clean it up, and to the tune of hundreds of thousands of dollars. And they cannot sell their property, they cannot sell their business, and they cannot retire because the DNR is forcing them to clean up somebody else's pollution, which is, in our view, incredibly unfair. As I said, when they bought that property in the 80s, they had no idea that years ago there was a gasoline station there. That was not disclosed to them in the real estate transaction. They had absolutely nothing to do with the petroleum that leaked and contaminated that property. So we think it's totally unfair for the DNR to say, no, you don't get to retire, you don't get to sell your business, you don't get to, you know, live out your golden years as you planned and invested for, because we're going to require you to use your retirement savings to clean up somebody else's pollution. And I just don't know anybody who could possibly think that that's a fair and just thing for the Wisconsin Department of Natural Resources to do.